everyone, it's Michelle from Country Morning Creations, and I'm here with the tutorial I promised to do on how to make your own digital kits, if you will, or digital prints for your own journals. So I'm starting out, I'm just in Google. This is the one that I use, Google Chrome. You can use Safari, you can use Firefox. They all play well with Canva. And we're using Canva because it's a free program that actually will, you can do a lot of things with it. So I'm going to adjust my camera up just a little bit higher so you can see, and I'm just going to type in C, and you can see it comes up already, canva.com, and that's where you want to go. I'm going to hit my enter button. And it comes up, I'm already signed in. So what you'll need to do is create your own account. You can see this is the username they gave me up here. If you have another one, that, you know, if you have a specific name you want to use, you can use that. But this is what they gave me, and this is my account. And what you'll see is over here on the homepage, you have all your designs. So as you design things, it's all right here. There are templates, there are photos, there's print, there's brand kit. So if you have the professional thing, this tells you about your brand, and then design school. So they have tons and tons over here of really great tutorials. So if you're not sure what to do, do that. And then I don't know what else is down here. Oh, and then folders. So you can keep things in folders. That's further down. You can see that right here, you can just do a search if you wanted to. I'm going to move this camera down a little bit because we're going to be doing most of our work down in this part. So you see you have the option to create a design. Designs are already here, things like that. Instagram posts. So these are things that you could create if you wanted to, or you can use these already. So there's a lot of different options here. So what I want to do, and you can see that if you go over here, right here, you can click and you can scroll through these and they'll give you different things. But what I want to use right now is this little custom dimensions up here. Now I use inches, so we need to change it from pixels to inches. And it, you can see here you have inches, millimeters, centimeters, or pixels. For what I'm doing, I want to use inches because I know that my paper is 8.5 by 11. However, I want it to be 11 this way so that when I fold it in half, it fits neatly in my journals. So we're going to type in 11 here and 8.5 in this bar, and we're going to click on Create a New Design. Your internet may be faster than mine. I live way out in the country and our internet is pretty slow. So what you'll see is on the left-hand side over here, these are different things that you can use. I recommend that you click on them and have fun. I mean, these are all different kinds of things. You can hover over it. Some of these are free and they'll be actually marked free. Like, see how that pops up and says free? So some of this is free and you can just use these. And I've actually used this picture before because it was pink and it worked really well. So anyway, this is not a tutorial about all this stuff. This is a tutorial about creating your own designs. So I want to keep it pretty short and to just those designs. So if you saw my, this was my journal and I created this design and I saved it. So it's in there already, but we're going to go through that again. So this journal is 8.5. And then the pages are 8.5, so they become 4.25 wide. It's very similar to a traveler's notebook size, but not exactly. So the first thing I want to do is I want to make the background a specific size. So I'm coming over here to elements and I want shapes. And I actually know I want this square, and you can see it pops up that that square shape is free. Now you can see that it comes up as a gray color, and up here in the corner, I don't know if you can see that or not, let's scan this up a little bit. Up here in the corner, that's the color that this is, and I want that actually to be a pink. So I'm going to pick this pink to start with. But that's not the color pink I want to use. I want to make it lighter, and you'll get this. When you click on the plus, you get this. And this you can take and you can make it darker or lighter, and you can just move this bubble. And I want it to be lighter, so we're going to move this right up at the top to about right there. So now I have the square the color I want, but this isn't the size that I want. So I'm going to come back over and click on this. And as I move this up, you will see right here that it's changing. I want it to be 8.5 inches high. So this is all in inches because I started out in inches. So now it's 8.5 inches high. I'm going to move that down. And then we want it 8.5 inches wide for what I'm using. Now, if you're doing a traveler's notebook, you need to make these, you can make this square any size you want. And that is one of the things that I love about this, is we can make this any size we want. So you can see, you know, you're totally centered when those lines come up. And so now it's completely centered. So theoretically, if I were to make a second page and I wanted to print them back to back, theoretically, they should print right on the other, and I should be able to just cut those ends off. You want to print it this way with the open ends instead of at one end, because you want it to be centered in your paper. So this is just a kind of a safer way to do it. Now, one of the things that I did was I uploaded some roses from the Graphics Fairy. I have a premium design membership. I'm part of their premium membership. So I uploaded those. So if you'll see, I'm going to come over here to uploads, and I'm going to click on that. And you'll see these are the roses that I already uploaded. Because I want to upload them, you've got two options. You can either click on it, and there it is. I'm going to delete it. Or you can just drag and drop them. Basically, it does the same thing. Now, I don't want this to be this big on this page, because as you can see, that would just take up the whole page. If you want it that big, just leave it that big. One of the nice things about the Graphics Fairy stuff, and this really isn't an advertisement for them, but one of the great things about them is that they really have high quality images. So you can make them big or small, and they're going to print out beautifully. So as you can see, as we, instead of doing it this way, if you do it this way, it will squish it. And if you squish it down like this, that's not what I want. So I'm going to go up here to this button, and that's going to convert it back. I want to use the whole image. So as I'm squishing it down, you can see it's 4 inches by 5.7 inches, and I want it to be 2 inches tall. So we're going to take it down to the 2-inch tall. And I'm just going to drag it. Oops. Oh, whoops. Well, I messed it up. Let's try that again. Now, I'm just going to grab it and put it up in the corner here. And then I click out here, and now everything goes away, and you can see that it's ready to go. Now, the next thing I did was I created corners. And one of the things that you can do is, these are elements, and you go to elements, and it saved all my recently used elements. And the way I found this one was to go into corner, and I typed in corner, and that was actually one of the first ones that came up. And again, you can see that it is free. There's tons of free stuff in here. So if you just drag that over, you'll see that the element starts out in black. Now, it depends on what your background color is, so it tries to predetermine what color you want. What I did was I simply went up to this little box here. You click on that. That's your color. I want it to be white. So now that I have it white, again, it's too big. So let's make this 2 inches. I'm going to move that up into here so we can see it. And we're going to make it 2 inches tall and put it up in this corner. So now I have my corners and my roses, and this is basically all I did, and then printed it to coffee dyed paper. But I want to show you one more thing you can do. One of the things, if you go back over here to your elements, is to, I looked up winter because I wanted to do something that was wintry, and I found this image way down here. We'll scroll this up a little bit. I like this image. So I wanted to use that image. So I'm going to drag that one over here. And you can see that it's really big. But right now, Christmas stuff is really popular in the pinks. So instead of leaving this in the red, I want to make this in the pink. So let's go up here. That is this red. And let's make it pink instead. And then this red is a darker color. I want to make that more of maybe, let's make it a dark purple. So now all the berries are this dark purple. So I can change out all these colors and make them different. So maybe I don't like the olive green of those. I want to make that more of, I want those branches to be more that same green. So I click on that and now they're all green. So I've completely changed all the colors pretty much in this image. So you can go in if you use an image from Canva and change the colors if you get these blocks up here. Some of them are locked and some of them are not. So if you get these colors, you can even go in and change all the different colors. So now I'm going to delete that. I want to download this. And the first thing I try to do is make sure that I give it a title. So we're going to do tutorial. And I'm going to give it that name. So when I download it, I will know that that is what it is. And I find that I have to click out of everything and click kind of up in this white space to make sure everything is ready to download. And then I just go over here and it says download. You can download it as a PNG, a JPEG, a PDF standard, or a PDF print. I recommend you choose either of these. PDF works better if you kind of have a regular computer, a PC. JPEGs work really well if you have a Mac, and I have a Mac. So I'm going to download this as a Mac, and I'm going to click the download. And you'll see this preparing your design come up. You want to give it time to do that. This is just a blank. So I'm going to click out of that and you'll see that the tutorial came up. I like to store things on my desktop. You can store them wherever you want. And you just come down here and you click save. And now you have your design and you're ready to then go to your computer and print it out. So I hope you've enjoyed this little tutorial, and I kept it pretty short. Yay, it's only about 13 minutes. So anyway, I hope you enjoyed this tutorial on Canva. I will be doing more tutorials along the lines. I actually have another tutorial on how to make a thumbnail for your YouTube channel if you choose to keep that. So I'm going to try to keep doing more of these. I love Canva because it's online, it saves all my stuff online, and it also is just really super easy to use. I want to encourage you to go in. You can see that right now a lot of Christmassy stuff is out there. You can use a lot of this if you're trying to do a Christmas journal, if you're trying to do other things. So this is just a great tool, and I hope that you've seen anything in here or something in here that's encouraged you to be creative today.